Tommy, how you doing?
I'm good, mate. Very well. Yourself?
Yeah, good. Thank you, mate. You must be champing at the bit to get back in that ring.
Yeah, definitely. It's been a long time since I've been in there. My last fight was in December, so pretty much a year that I've not been out for. And obviously, as a young fighter, it's not what we hope for. But, you know, hey, the world's facing something that we all didn't hope for. So at the end of the day, as long as we're all fit and healthy, that's all that matters. And we're here now. You know, we're 2 days, 3 days away from the fight. And yeah, I can't wait to get in there.
Yeah, it's hard to believe it's a year since you last fought when you were showing off your Christmas undercrackers at the weigh-in. And then
I've got some crackers for this one.
Have you?
Got some good ones, Ari. You'll see on Thursday afternoon the crackers. I think they're up there, in my opinion, but we'll see, won't we?
Oh, that's a little tease for everyone there to tune in. So that's for the weigh-in, presumably. Are you wearing those?
That's for the weigh-in, yes.
Okay. Well, I'll wait with bated breath for that one, mate. So, fourth professional fight, last two first round KOs, more of the same, do you think?
Yeah, definitely. At the end of the day, I just want to go in there and, you know, just do what I do and box. But I never look for the knockout because I believe looking for knockouts is not the best thing to do because if you look for them, they normally don't come. So, I'm just going to go in there, box like I can. And if you can get some rounds out, it'll be nice because, as I say, I've been a pro since, been a pro for 2 years now. And only had three fights, so I need as much rounds as I can get. So if the fight goes long, it goes long, all the better. But if not, you know, we don't get paid for overtime, do we?
Very true. I mean, I know it's the same. Everyone's in the same boat as far as the lack of crowd goes. But for yourself, particular crowd puller, crowd pleaser, it's going to be quite strange for you to be in there with, you know, only a handful of people.
Yeah, of course, it's going to be different, something that I haven't experienced before. But at the end of the day, it's a fight. And for me, it's just going to be like another fight, you know, just no people there, a couple of cameras on me, a couple of lights, and that's it. I'll get in and do the job, and then I'll get straight back to the gym and go back to the drawing board. You know, a crowd for me, you know, obviously it's 10 times better with a crowd. We all know that, and we all wish things get back to normal as soon as possible. But, you know, we can't hum an hour about it. It is what it is. We've got to go on and please all the fans sitting at home.
Yeah, I mean, talk about the crowd please, and obviously, you know, you've had a year of, you know, or more of celebrity status and all the rest of it, but I know for you personally, what you want to do now is be taken seriously as a boxer.
Yeah, 100%. You know, that's what I'm in the gym for every single day. That's what I'm working for. That's what I'm working towards. I'm not practicing my modelling or anything like that. I'll practice and get my makeup done, right? I'm practicing avoiding getting my nose spread all over my face. So they want to be taking me seriously, or else what's the point in doing it? No, all jokes aside, yeah, Love Island was a good stint that I did in my career, but, you know, I am a fighting man. I've been doing it basically all my life, as everybody knows. So I just want to get in there and show everybody that I am to be took seriously, and I'm not interested in doing boxing to get a bit of money. Oh, look, I'm having a fight on Friday. Everyone follow me on Instagram, get me a bit more followers. No. Not about that. I'm going in there to showcase my skills and get better as a boxer.
Yeah, and as you said before, I mean, it's only your fourth fight. It is very early on in your career. What stage do you think, you know, maybe move up to the next level? Because you at the moment you're having 4 6 rounders. I believe this one's a 4 rounder. So next logical step is either another 6 rounder or a 10. Where do you see it going at the moment?
It's really hard to say. I mean, at the end of the day, the only person who's going to step me up is, you know, my team. And my dad, you know, whatever they feel stage where I'm at, then that's where I'll be. You know, if I don't, you know, feel like I'm ready, I'm not going to force myself into fights that are just way ahead of me. You know, I'm 21 years old. I've had 10 amateur fights, so there's no rush. I just want to take my time and learn my job properly and, you know, the more experience I get, the more better I'll get. So at the end of the day, you know, I'll step up when the time's right. And at the minute, we'll just focus on getting experience, getting some rounds in and perfecting the job properly.
No, absolutely. I mean, but despite the inexperience, you are still a name. And there's a US website this week, put 2 and 2 together, came up with 5, linking you with a fight with Deontay Wilder's brother next year. Yeah. I guess you are going to get that sort of stuff, aren't you? Because you know, A, because you're a name in your own right, and B, because of your family, Tyson, and the rest of them.
Yeah, of course. Yeah, I've seen a few of them stories flying about. It's I think it's gone mad with itself, hasn't it, again? But No, I'm not looking past anything or not looking at anything except for Friday night. You know, every fight at this level and every level is a world title fight for me. You know, if you can't take your eye off the ball for 1 second in this game, because we've seen stranger things happen.
Yeah, I mean, those fights, that rumour, or it wasn't even a rumour really, but that stuff about Marcellus Wilder, for starters, he'd have to drop down a weight. But that came about, I think, because you were responding to Deontay's sort of latest accusations, if you like, about Tyson.
Yeah. No, they asked me the question, so I'm going to give them the answers, and I'll stand by it all the way. I think it's ludicrous what he's coming out with, you know, talking about his trainers spiked his water and his outfit was too heavy for him and Tyson had a brick in his glove. What more does he want to say? You know, he lost the fight fair and square. Just accept it like a man and move on. That's what you've got to do, and that's what I feel like every sportsman should be, you know. If you lose a fight, you lose a fight. There's no hard stuff about it, you know. Just go back to the drawing board and try again next time, you know. All these excuses ain't going to put a W on his record or resurrect that decision and put a W there. Ain't going to happen, so just quit while you're ahead, mate. Nobody wants to hear it, really.
And they're sort of penciled in for the, well, you know, more than penciled in for the trilogy fight, but there's interesting news and reports from the WBC this week that they might let Tyson sidestep that and then go on to fight AJ, which I guess is the fight everyone really wants to see.
Well, it makes more sense, doesn't it? I mean, everyone's seen Wilder and Tyson now twice. Tyson's beaten both times, convincingly, in pretty much everybody's opinion. And everyone wants to see the AJ fight now. You know, it's a fight that's not happened yet. That's the one we're all looking forward to. And hopefully, you know, if the world shapes up and everyone, you know, gets better and it all goes to plan, hopefully we can see that next year.
I think we've discussed this before, but and obviously I know what you're going to say, but it'll be a great fight if it happens, but B, I think you're pretty sure what the outcome would be.
Yeah, 100%. I've always said it, and I always will say it, you know, I think Joshua is going to be Tyson's easiest fight, just purely on the fact that, you know, Wilder is obviously cliche, very wild with his punches, you know, he's here, there and everywhere. If they can come from the top, they can come from the bottom, they can come from the side, you know, you don't really know what you're getting with him. But with Joshua, if you look at, you know, every single one of his fights from his very first fight to his very last fight, they're all very similar. You know, he's there, he comes forward, he's got the 1-2 and then a hook and then an uppercut inside. You know, a man like that for Tyson, that style is tailor-made for Tyson. And the way Tyson's going about his business now, he's like a different man. He's punching walls down. He's a big man and he's hitting very hard. And that should intimidate anyone. You know, he's 6'9", he's only 20 stone of pure power, and he's on the front foot and he's coming and he's taking you down. And I just think it only goes one way for Joshua, that fight.
Finally on you, so what can we expect on what can we expect on Friday?
You can expect lights, cameras, action, and away we go. You know, hopefully I'm gonna get in the ring, I'm gonna do what I've been doing in the gym, I'm gonna showcase my skills. And yeah, listen, it's the entertainment business, so you're going to be entertained one way or another. So definitely tune in and don't miss it live on BT Sport.
Brilliant. And hopefully you'll be back unscathed to watch the main event, which looks quite tasty.
Yeah, 100%. Get finished up, watch the main event. And yeah, definitely, it's going to be a cracking fight. I think the fans are the real winners in this one, because obviously it's a rematch, the first fight. You know, if any match should be a draw, it should have been that one, because it was very, very close. Both good men, and I can't wait to see it on Friday night.